Folks, the winner of today's game will be taking home the statue of a pig named Floyd of Rosedale. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. The 41-yard line.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. Quick release. Oh, had it knocked down.
Well, the key to that defensive play was the fact that the quarterback put a little bit too much air underneath it. That allowed the safety to come over and bat the ball away.
And he's hit immediately. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He's at the 40. And they push him out around the 35-yard line. So this young man continues to exceed all expectations here in the first half.
Unbelievable, Brad. This guy is just on fire right now. I don't think anyone can bring him down after that first hit.
Nice run to the outside.
That brings him second and five.
It's second and five here. Ball on the 30. And he's tackled around the 27-yard line.
Gain of three on the play. That'll make it third and one.
Can't hang on to him. And now he's got room to run. And they make the stop just outside the goal line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
He makes the PAT. An 8-play, 74-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
Stevens has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. Goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Brought down right around the 42-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. And he's taken down at the 41.
Call the loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Brody wins the fight. Oh, double.
Check nine.
Man left.
He's at midfield. Nice grab on the play. Tackle made around the 43-yard line.
16 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Tyler gets another carry. They'll bring him down around the 42-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Great concentration to pull it in. He's tackled at the 33.
You know, if you use him in this offense the right way, it's almost like you have an extra wide receiver. He's that good.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Pitch out, got the corner. Knocked out of bounds, right around the 30. Gets to about the 27-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. Not a lot on that one.
Usually you get a linebacker covering the tight end, so they might want to try some longer passes to exploit that mismatch.
The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he got it.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
7-3, Iowa. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Nice run to the left there.
That makes it second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on the 29-yard line. Iowa holds a 4-point lead. He rifles it. They can't connect. Incomplete.
Number 10, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
Hey, check back 33. Check back 33.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Johnson comes away with 5 yards on the carry.
Fourth down.
Taylor to punt. Booming kick. This one will go into the end zone and they'll bring it out to the 20. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he tackles him hard at the 17-yard line. From their own 17-yard line. Second down. He chucks it downfield. He goes up and gets it. Got an opening to the 10. And a huge touchdown play. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A quick two-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So our score, 10-7. The Golden Gophers. Minnesota lines up for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Tries to thread the needle. It's picked off. He's taken down at the 36.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
We've got a first and 10.
Ball on the 36-yard line. Minnesota holds a field goal lead. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, it can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
Gets out to around the 22. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
It's first and 10.
Ball on the 22-yard line.
Green 9, green up.
There he goes. Touchdown, Golden Gophers. And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Oh, what a hit. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Got it. And he goes down quickly. The quarterback really kept his poise under pressure and delivered a pretty nice little ball right there.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. And down he goes, around the 46-yard line. He makes it to the 48-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. And he shoved out of bounds at the 47.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. Third down.
Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
Oh, excellent punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same. He is drilled at the 30.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. And he's level at the 22. The 33-yard line.
The tight end picks up a lot of yardage on that one.
The big guy isn't the fastest out there, but he sure is a load to bring down.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Makes it to the 21. Gets out to about the 21.
That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line. Again with a carry. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Carr, and big hit there to stop him. So it's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Away, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. They'll bring him down at the 22-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Makes it to the 31. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line. And that one goes for about 5 yards and first down.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap and he threw it right out there. Under heavy pressure. He airs it out. And he hauls it in. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 20-7, Golden Gophers.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
It's all about perspective. Everybody who loves offense loved that first half.
lots of big plays, explosive plays. Offense has really got into the rhythm. But then there's the responsible opposing view, finding all the things that went wrong on the defensive side.
Yeah, it's twofold. You know, there's an offense and there's a defense. And at some point,
I'm glad you've noticed that.
Yeah, well, I didn't notice it in the first half, but
I wanted one side in the first half.
I'd like to notice more of it in the second half. And it's as simple. When a wide receiver catches a slant at 7 yards and takes it 70, there's a problem. Somebody needs to hit the guy. Somebody needs to be a little bit physical. Somebody needs to be willing to tackle the guy and bring him to the ground. Too many missed tackles, too many explosive plays. And if you play defense like that, you should probably look in behind you and say, I think I'm going to get the other guy in because he's got to be better than this guy that's starting.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 23. Golden Gophers having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series.
He's tackled at the 40.
17 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 40-yard line. First down. He makes his way to about the 48.
That's good for a gain of 12 yards. First down.
Right, Roger. Four down. Check nine. 31's the mic. Go.
Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield. From the 50. Second down. And he just gets rid of it. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. There's a strike complete. He's down. Puts it away, and it's a great kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. There's a strike complete. He's tackled at the 31. From their own 31-yard line, it's first down. Tackle made around the 36-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 37.
Gain of 1 on the play. That'll make it 35.
It's 3rd and 5. Ball on the 37.
Check mark 33.
Just throws this one away. Hoskins is back deep to return. It's away, and it's a booming punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
The defense has gotten a good dose of this young man's abilities today, Kirk.
I think overall we're getting a good feel of why he's one of the top quarterbacks in the country. He's throwing the ball from the pocket. At times he's taking off and scrambling and throwing on the run. And of course he has the athletic ability to be able to make big plays with his feet. I think it's just a combination of his skills. He's got the strong arm, great athletic ability, and also the awareness of when to take off with it. It's just kept this defense on their heels the entire game.
They're ready to begin another drive.
He's out to the 30. He's to the 40. And he's finally taken down at the 45.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on their own 45. He might have a chance. He's at the 40. And he's taken down at the 39-yard line. First down, Grant. Brought down around the 25-yard line.
First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 25.
30 was the mic.
Red 2.
Knocked out of bounds around the 24-yard line.
That's good for a game of one yard. That brings up second and 9.
And he hits him hard at the 13.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 13-yard line. Gets it out quickly. Touchdown, Minnesota!
How the quarterback, the offensive line, and the receivers made a concerted effort to get into the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 20-yard line.
Minnesota's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
They'll run it. They bring him down in the backfield.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 19-yard line, second down. He's taken down around the 28-yard line. Bring him down at about the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line, first down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
Double tight. Double tight. Four down, four
check, 33.
And down.
247.
And he stopped behind the line.
Really good job by the big guys up front to use their size and speed and get the runner in the backfield.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. One more quarter to play. The Golden Gophers lead it by 20. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Mike check, 33.
Right down.
Motion, 94.
Let's go, motion, motion.
And then, 94.
Here they come. Fires it quickly. That's a huge, huge stop here in the fourth quarter. They've got the lead. They're going to get the football back, but there's still a lot of ball left.
That'll bring up fourth.
So they're going to go for it here. Caught with room to work. And down he goes at the 46. This is the eighth play of this drive. Out of bounds, around the 44-yard line.
Second and nine.
Second and nine. Ball on the 44-yard line.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 33. Check Mike 33.
Quick pass. Tackle to the 33-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Make the stop right around the 24-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. He's hit and taken down. This is the 12th play of this drive. He gets to about the 5.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Gets to about the 5-yard line.
That'll make it third and one.
And this is the 14th play of the drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. They'll get him for a loss.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Well, they're looking for another fourth down conversion. They've already gotten one this drive. Finds a man, touchdown. Nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
You talk about a clutch play. They couldn't afford any mistakes on fourth down there. And he adds the extra point.
A long 15-play, 80-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown.
He's tackled at the 45-yard line.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
Inside handoff. He tackles him for a loss.
We've got a second and 11.
Ball on the 46-yard line.
Guys taking their first time out of the half.
He keeps it on the option and picks up maybe four.
Just under two to go in the game.
Gains his way to the 33-yard line. What a run.
Here they give it to the tailback and a little misdirection play, and you can see the athleticism and the ability to make guys miss. Nice play.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Tyler picks up about 4 yards on the play.
It's second down, five to go.
Ball in the 29. He's at the 20. Touchdown! Huge play! Tacks on the extra point. Minnesota kicked this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Passes left, going the other way. To the 20. And he's tackled around the 8-yard line.
So the turnover will once again give the ball back to this offense.
That's two interceptions today by this defense. Their coach has to be happy that they're forcing turnovers.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. A little over a minute in the game.
He fights forward to about the 7.
There on the quarterback keeper.
That makes us a winning goal.
Watch nine, watch nine. Me and you all day, all day.
Red, two, you. Yellow, three, you. Yellow, three.
And so that's going to do it. Golden Gophers get the victory, 34-14. As we wrap this game up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
They've talked about the rivalry all week long, and for good reason. We saw the intensity down on the field every play, and it showed us why these teams love to hate each other. It'll be interesting to see how this game carries over to the next time they play.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.